back to the special edition of Hannity's America. We now turn to admitted and unrepentant terrorist William Ayers and the relationship with him that Obama continues to try and downplay.
In the 1970s, a notorious organization called the Weather Underground was one of America's most radical groups of terrorists. Led by William Ayers, the Weather Underground was a violent anti-American group that was formed on the campus of the University of Michigan during the midst of the anti-war and civil rights movements. In 1970, they issued a declaration of a state of war against the United States government. Members adopted different identities and plotted acts of terror that included the bombing of the U.S. Capitol, the Pentagon, New York City Police Headquarters, military recruitment centers, and several other government buildings. Eventually, they landed on the FBI's 10 most wanted list. While the group's main targets were the government establishments, one night in 1970, they made one very personal attack. It was on February 21st when William Ayers and the Weathermen went after John Murtaugh and his entire family. Murtaugh was presiding over the trial of another group of terrorists, 21 members of the Black Panther Party, who were indicted in a plot to bomb New York landmarks and department stores.
February 21st, 1970. I had just turned nine about 2 months earlier. It was pre-trial, jury selection. About 2 o'clock in the morning, our entire family, four of us, actually five of us, my sister, my brother, my parents, were awakened to three firebombs, carefully placed, two at the front entrance of the house, one by the back door underneath the tank of the family car.
And by the way, the morning after, when the sunlight comes out, three sentences revealed blood red graffiti on the sidewalk. Free the Panther 21, the Viet Cong have won, and kill the pigs.
That's right. And it's also important to remember, Sean, that we were one of three sites bombed that night around New York City.
Right.
It wasn't just our house.
Yeah, no one ever caught or was tried for the attempt on your family's life here, because the one underneath the car literally was under the gas tank, right?
That's right. That's right. And Thank God a neighbor actually managed to put that out before it actually exploded.
The Murtaugh family survived, but the Weathermen weren't finished yet. That same night, bombs were thrown at a police car in Manhattan and two military recruiting stations in Brooklyn, New York. Over the years, many members would turn and leave the group. The remaining fugitives operated underground. While on the run, William Ayers married fellow Weatherman terrorist Bernadine Dorn. In 1981, the two finally turned themselves in and were tried but not convicted because of prosecutorial misconduct. After the trial, Ayers and his wife tried to integrate back into society, and he went back to school, began teaching, and was also, quote, a community leader. It was his position as a, quote, community leader that would lead Ayers and Barack Obama to cross paths. It was in 1995 that Ayers and his wife hosted a political coming out party at their Chicago home for a young Barack Obama. As you can now imagine, though, Obama is now downplaying his association with his radical friends. The Obama campaign describes the relationship between Obama and Ayers as quote-unquote friendly, but Hannity's America has discovered much more. Besides the coming out party in 1995, Senator Barack Obama also served as a director for the nonprofit Woods Fund of Chicago from 1999 to 2002, alongside his friend William Ayers. In addition, both Ayers and Obama have also appeared together at various public speaking engagements. In 2002, they spoke together at a forum in Chicago, sponsored in part by the University of Illinois, titled Intellectuals, Who Needs Them? Obama and Ayers were on a panel of just six people. It would seem that they are a little bit more than just, quote, friendly. But Obama continues to hedge and weave over this relationship. In April, during a primary debate, George Stephanopoulos asked Senator Obama about these ties.
Can you explain that relationship for the voters and explain to Democrats why it won't be a problem?
George, but this is an example of what I'm talking about. This is a guy who lives in my neighborhood, who's a professor of English in Chicago, who I know and who I have not received some official endorsement from. He's not somebody who I exchange ideas from on a regular basis. And the notion that somehow, as a consequence of me knowing somebody who engaged in detestable acts 40 years ago when I was 8 years old, somehow reflects on me and my values doesn't make much sense, George.
But as Obama tries to downplay their relationship and distance himself from the unrepentant terrorists, we cannot forget this past that he's trying to bury. We also must remember that Obama and Ayers do have a history together. And Ayers still refuses to apologize for his horrific acts of terror. In fact, of all days, September 11, 2001, the very day the United States was attacked by Muslim extremists, Ayers told the New York Times, quote, "I don't regret setting bombs. I feel we didn't do enough," unquote. When asked if he would do it all over again, he said, quote, "I don't want to discount the possibility." So it looks like we just have another case of Obama and his radical friends and their history of radicalism.
And joining us now is Larry Krathwohl. Larry, welcome to Hannity's America. Thanks for being with us.
Glad to be here.
A phenomenal story. For a year, you infiltrated the Weather Underground. You know and knew personally Bernadine Dorn and Bill Ayers. You began working for the FBI. You even moved into the home of the Weather Underground, right? And that included Bill Ayers. You live with him.
Yes. Yes, I did.
For a year. Tell us about that time.
Well, I was, after the group went underground in December 1969, I was assigned to various cells in Detroit, Michigan, Madison, Wisconsin, Buffalo, New York. During those periods, I lived with various members of the group in which Bill was the leader and would either stay with us or leave and come back and take charge of the group.
Now, you were there with Bill Ayers and sat at a kitchen table, and he specifically not only taught you how to build a bomb, but actually drew pictures of it and actually told you what cities to target, correct?
Yes. When we were in Detroit, two targets were picked out, the Detroit Police Officers Association building in the 13th Precinct. There was some kind of a trial going on involving police officers. And he told us what buildings we should bomb. He assigned the people to the various locations. And when I objected, because the DPOA building was next door to a restaurant, and then it was my belief that the bomb would kill more people in the restaurant than anyone in this old brownstone building in Detroit, he told me that in a revolution, innocent people have to die.
We really appreciate you being with us on Hannity's America. Thank you, sir. And coming up, he sat in the pews of Jeremiah Wright's church for over 20 years. But how close was Senator Obama to his former pastor? We examine their relationship coming up next. And then this man is a former employee of the Palestinian Liberation Organization who openly speaks about the destruction of Israel. We're going to tell you about his connection to Obama. That's coming up straight ahead on this special edition of Hannity's America.